Yes, so friends, today I plan to complete in the next 1 hour the following topics: scope of variables in JavaScript, where we are going to see three types of variables: local, global, and automatically global. Then, very simple concept called block statement. Again, a very simple thing called what are the different types of data which we can have in JavaScript. Of course, in JavaScript, there is no requirement to declare a data type. We only declare a variable. JavaScript is just like Python. When you put some data into a variable, automatically, depending upon the data, depending upon the literal which you write on the right side, that's what you write on the right side is called as literal. Literal means some constant. So true, or this absolute number 3.142, or this integer number 34, or the string ABC, all of them are literals. So when you put a 34 into the variable age, JavaScript understands that age is an integer. It's a number. It's an integer number. When you put 3.142 into pi, he understands it's a floating point number. By the way, in JavaScript, floating point integers both are counted as numbers only. JavaScript doesn't distinguishes them between floating point and integer. So we will be see this. We will take some examples. Then we'll be looking at how to declare an array or an array object. They're one and the same thing in JavaScript. And there are two ways of doing it. One is by using array constructor, second by using array literal notation. After this, some simple tryouts for a home assignment for today. Then, how do you declare object? This is a very interesting thing in JavaScript, very super interesting. How do you create an object? Creating an object in JavaScript is much easier as compared to maybe probably making it in Python or in Java, where in other languages you first have to make a class, and after making a class, you make an object. So all that trouble is not there in JavaScript. In JavaScript, there are three ways in all to make an object. This is one of the simplest way to make an object, where we write key value pairs, in a pair of brace brackets. So within brace brackets, you are making key value pairs. And this is the way you make an object in JavaScript. So we're going to see this practically. After that, some a quick find output question. Then we are going to look at something, what is a DOM, document object model. And there are many ways in JavaScript to access an HTML element. So you can write a JavaScript code and access each and every HTML element in the HTML page by using these get functions. We will see an example of get element by ID, get elements, look at the S here, get elements by name. So that means you can get more than one element at a time. Get element by ID, get element by ID will get only one element, but get elements by name would get or can get many elements at the same time. Get elements by tag name will only get elements by tag name will also get many elements, but and by the tag name. So we will probably see the examples for all these three. Okay, not for the fourth one and not for the fifth one for the time being. This is what the objective is. Okay, so we will finish these three examples on page number 97, 98, and 99. Okay, right. This is my plan for the next 1 hour, friends. So let's start with the scope of variables. Now, friends, what happens is when we actually declare variables in JavaScript, variable could be local. A local variable is something which is declared inside a function. So within a script, अगर आप कोई भी variable function के अंदर डिक्लेयर करते हो, एग्जाम्पल आई हैव डिक्लेयर अ वेरिएबल कॉल्ड लोकल वार इक्वल टू 3 इनसाइड द फंक्शन हियर, दिस इज कॉल्ड अ लोकल वेरिएबल. दिस इज ओनली एक्सेसिबल इनसाइड द फंक्शन. फंक्शन के बाहर आप लोकल वार को एक्सेस नहीं कर सकते. यू कैन नॉट प्रिंट और यूज इट. व्हाट इज ग्लोबल वेरिएबल? एनी वेरिएबल विच यू डिक्लेयर एट द स्क्रिप्ट लेवल, फंक्शन के बाहर at the script level. For example, I've declared an array here which says that I have an array in which the elements, there are two elements in this. One is an array and there are two elements in this. One is lion, other is tiger. So in this array, at the 0th location, I hold lion. At first location, I hold tiger. And I'm trying to print array of 0. I'm sure you will agree that it's going to print the word lion. Now, there is a function called dummy. But function dummy ke andar abhi mat jaiye. Jab tak kisi bhi function ko hum call na kare na, uske andar mat jaya karo. Okay, so I can skip this entire thing. Please skip it. Come here. Document.write, everybody knows, is supposed to print statement in JavaScript. So what I'm doing is, document.write se main print kar raha hu, whatever is the return value, jo bhi return value hoga dummy function ka, usse main print kar raha hu. So dummy function kaise kuch return karega? As you can see here, you're calling the dummy function. So from here, there is a call going to this point. So when dummy function is being called, let us see if this dummy function returning something. Remember, whatever dummy function is printing is his work. He is printing it. That's not going to come and return. Return will only happen if there is a proper return statement written. Agar return statement likha hoga aur uske aage koi value return ki jari hogi, to hi kuch return aayega is point document.write ke paas. Unfortunately, देखकर दिखता है, if you just see, उसमें समझ में आ जाता है कि function dummy के अंदर मेरे पास एक भी return statement नहीं है. And because I don't have a return statement inside the function dummy, so it's very natural that this function dummy is not returning anything. Then what will this document.write print? We will see it practically. Okay, what is going to print? But let's see what function dummy prints. Function dummy is printing array of 1. Everybody in the class knows that's going to be tiger, because array is a global variable as it is declared at the script level, and the value at the index 1 is tiger. Next, local var is 3. You printed local var is going to print 3. What is auto global? I've just declared a variable. This could be having any name. But I have declared a variable without the var keyword. This is different. This is different as well as interesting. Inside a function, if you declare any variable without the var keyword, then in JavaScript, there is a new scope which is not available in other languages, and it is called as automatically global. Means, आपने वेरिएबल डिक्लेयर तो किया है फंक्शन के अंदर, लेकिन इसको आप फंक्शन के बाहर भी यूज कर सकते हो. तो रॉकी सर, फिर डिफरेंस क्या है? ये भी डिक्लेयर किया है, लोकल वार भी. लोकल वार को डिक्लेयर करते समय आपने वार कीवर्ड लिखा था. इफ यू राइट द वार कीवर्ड एंड डिक्लेयर अ वेरिएबल इनसाइड अ फंक्शन, it is going to be a simple local variable. But if you drop the var keyword, then this particular variable will be automatically global. Okay? Now, so this variable here is automatically global, and therefore this variable can be accessed outside the function also. Really? Yes, I am accessing it. See this? मैं एक्सेस कर रहा हूं. जब मैं इसको यहां प्रिंट करूंगा तो आप नोटिस करोगे प्रैक्टिकली कि आपको आंसर 30 आता है. नाउ द ओनली पॉइंट एट विच वी डू नॉट नो व्हाट द आउटपुट इज गोइंग टू बी इज दिस पॉइंट. लेट्स सी प्रैक्टिकली. वन थिंग इज 100% दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर फंक्शन कॉल्ड डमी इज नॉट रिटर्निंग एनीथिंग. देयर इज नो रिटर्न वैल्यू ऑफ दिस फंक्शन. ओके, that is definite. So let us do one thing. Let us try to go one step ahead into our workspace. So friends, I want all of you to go to your workspace, please, and search for this program called scope of JavaScript variables. वर्कस्पेस का कौन सा फाइल आपको पिकअप करना है, जावास्क्रिप्ट एग्जांपल्स डॉट एचटीएमएल, इस फाइल में जाइए और इस फाइल में सर्च कीजिए स्कोप ऑफ जावास्क्रिप्ट वेरिएबल्स वाला कोड, आई एम वेटिंग, एंड मोमेंट यू रेडी यू विल से रेडी ऑन द चैट।
हेलो सर।
यस
सर, आई डोंट हैव दिस फाइल।
दिस फाइल इज इन द वर्कस्पेस। ओके पटेल और दुबे, कैन यू प्लीज गिव इट टू प्रतीक ऑन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप। So I hope by now you have got the, everybody has searched the file. Maybe Pratik will get the file, and Pratik, you may miss this program, not a problem. You may not be able to execute this, but you can execute on the next program. So in the meantime, you will get the file. Okay, now let me just run this piece of code. Please carefully see what output I have got for the 12th statement. Document.write, I've called a dummy function, but the dummy function has done its duty, but dummy function doesn't return anything. And because dummy function is not returning anything, kyunki dummy function kuch return nahi karta, iske liye notice kijiye ki ye jo print statement hai 12th line ka, dekho kya print karta hai. It prints undefined because nothing was returned by the function. Do you want to check if I return something, what is going to happen? Chalo, we will check that also. We'll put a return statement, okay, and we would return a string as testing dummy. Okay, so return testing dummy is being returned. I'll just refresh this program. Please see the output. So remember one thing, whenever you're calling a function, the return value is whatever you return to the return statement. If you do not return anything, let me comment this return statement for you, then output is always going to be undefined. Okay, I hope this is going very simple and clear. And second thing which you proved, the variable auto global वो हम लोगों ने डिक्लेयर किया है विदाउट द वार कीवर्ड, देयरफॉर इट इज ऑटो ग्लोबल, ऑटोमेटिकली ग्लोबल. नोटिस आई एम एक्सेसिंग द वेरिएबल एट लाइन नंबर 14 विच इज आउटसाइड द फंक्शन. द फंक्शन ओनली गोज फ्रॉम लाइन नंबर 5 टू लाइन नंबर 11. सो this step, line number 14, is very much outside the function, and you are able to access the variable auto global. Okay, I'm giving you 1 minute to run the code as well as ask your doubts, please. Okay, Vishwajit is done. What about others? Please, as you do it, please put done on the chat. Okay, Dubey says done. Very good.
Sir, wo last wala samjho na document or try kar.
Document.write is simply a print statement. It's just like to print. So when you do document.write, that is the reason you're getting the output on the screen here. It prints. डॉक्यूमेंट मीन्स दिस वेब पेज, ये जो करंट वेब पेज में आप हो ना उसको डॉक्यूमेंट बोलते हैं, एंड द करंट वेब पेज इज राइटिंग राइटिंग ऑन द ब्राउजर, देयरफॉर द आउटपुट कम्स हियर. क्लियर प्रतीक?
यस सर, यस सर,
यस. राइट, सो एज ऑल ऑफ यू हैव एक्नॉलेज्ड दैट यू हैव रन दिस कोड, सो नाउ यू आर वेरी क्लियर विद द थ्री डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ वेरिएबल स्कोप्स, लोकल, ग्लोबल एंड ऑटोमेटिकली ग्लोबल. नेक्स्ट, अ वेरी सिंपल फंडा कॉल्ड ब्लॉक स्टेटमेंट. इन जावास्क्रिप्ट putting a pair of brace brackets does not creates a block. If you compare JavaScript with any other language like C or C++ or Java or Python, of course in Python we cannot use a brace bracket at all, but if you compare with C, C++ and Java, you shouldn't get confused. In JavaScript you can use brace brackets, but brace brackets are not to be confused. So brace bracket is used for making a block of statements. But that does not means कि अगर ये स्टेटमेंट वन इस ब्लॉक के अंदर है तो वो इस ब्लॉक के अंदर ही यूज हो सकता है, ऐसा नहीं है. दिस स्टेटमेंट वन कैन बी यूजफुल, कैन बी यूजबल आउटसाइड द ब्लॉक हियर ऑल्सो. लेट्स टेक टेक अ क्विक एग्जाम्पल. आई हैव अ वेरिएबल एक्स विच आई हैव डिक्लेयर्ड होल्डिंग वन विद इन द ब्लॉक I made a variable x equal to 2. So technically speaking, the variable x which you made above, which was holding 1, you have changed its value from 1 to 2. So when you change the value to 2, you are, you know, if you are like a C, C++ or Java programmer, you will feel, oh, this is inside the block. So the moment you come out of the block, the value will revert back to 1. No, that does not happen in JavaScript. JavaScript कहता है, line number 1, value of x was 1. Line number 3, the same variable x has been changed to 2. Now it will remain 2, because the last change which you made was 2. So wherever I go to print, whether I print by writing console.log or I print by writing document.write, I will get the answer as 2. Okay, can anybody please explain in the class now, what is the difference between console.log and document.write?
Right.
Yeah, please Manish, please go ahead.
Document console.log means it will print on the console line.
Correct.
By printing F2L, if you are seeing the error or the signal, there we will see the output.
Correct.
And document write means we will see on the web page where we are running the file.
Perfect. Perfect. So Pratik, this already has been done because you missed the lecture. So what I'm doing is I'll just show you once. If I press F12, Pratik, I will notice that on my browser, the developer tools open up. Under the developer tools, I have a section called console. So whenever I run a piece of code which has console.log. So let's say that we go back to this code and we type console.log, and I'm typing Pratik here, and I'm going to put Pratik in the script open and the script close tag. Let me just refresh this code here. See Pratik, where is the output coming? On the console. The output didn't come on the screen. The output came on the console. But on the other hand, let me close the console. Now you can see the web page. If I change console.log to document.write and then I run this page, let me refresh it, I'll see the output coming on the web page. Okay, Pratik, now I hope it is clear. Okay?
Yes, sir.
Yes. So, friends, we have understood the scope variables. Now let's look at the data types. The data types are very simple, and most of them are like self-explanatory. So whenever you hold a boolean data or you put a boolean data into a variable, the variable internally becomes a boolean variable. When you put a number like this, it will internally become a number variable. When you put a string, it's going to internally become a string variable. How do you declare object variables? That I will teach you. How do you declare arrays? That's given here. So if you notice the difference between the two examples here, a very minor difference. In the first case, you're using the square bracket notation and you're declaring an array. So we say jab aap square bracket use karte ho to hum kehte hain ki aap array bana rahe ho without using the constructor. On the other hand, if you make an array by writing new array bracket open bracket close, you dump whatever you want to dump in the array here, then we say we are using constructor. What is a constructor? Constructor is a special predefined function in JavaScript. So when you write new array, you're making a new array. Within the brackets, you whatever you want to put into the array, you can write here. You will notice one very strange thing. Within the square bracket, you're wondering, why have you given two commas, Dr. Sir? No, actually not given two commas. Line is in the 0th index position. At the first index position, I have not put any element. So undefined will come there. Interesting. In JavaScript, you can also hold undefined as an input within the array. So 0, undefined, and tiger is in the second position. So it is going to be 2. Here, I have only put two elements only. At 0th location, line, first location, tiger. Simple. So there are two ways of declaring an array. Either you use square bracket notation, or you use new array to make an array. Now, there are some simple examples here, and I would like to request you to remember it also. When you are making an array using constructor, when you are making an array using constructor, that is writing new array, then you have the following different formats or different forms available. First form is you write new array and give it a size. Second, JavaScript is very smart. Wo kehta hai, even if you drop the new keyword, it is okay. You can write array 3 also. He will understand that you want to make a new array of size 3. But in both these cases, you have not put any data inside the array. Array is empty. It's of size 3, but it's empty. Okay. Third C, array. The array is actually holding two elements. It's of size 2 because it is holding two elements. These three cases, I have made an array by using constructor. That is by writing this word called array, A capital. Now, if I want to make an array by using square brackets, I can do that also. First case, I made an array of colors with three colors. Second case, I made an empty array of names. Third case, I made an array which is actually holding first element as 1, second element as 2, and the third element as undefined. Because after comma, there is nothing. Although JavaScript allows you to define arrays with undefined, you can also define arrays like this in JavaScript where everything is undefined, but please, humble request, avoid it. Why should I avoid it? You should avoid it because if you find the length of the array, now look here for values. Somebody can say values is having three elements, 1, 2, undefined. Somebody could say, array, let's ignore the undefined. Let's only consider the values 1 and 2. See, as a human, you want to say whatever you can say. Think from the point of view of the browser. When I found the length of values, I was shocked that in the case of Firefox, Safari, and Opera, I got length as 2. And in the case of Internet Explorer, I got length as 3. I'm giving this task to you. I'm giving this task to you that post the lecture, please try to play with this and try to find what is in Chrome. Is the Chrome reporting you length as 2 or reporting the length as 3? If it is reporting you the length of 2, that means it is only considering the first two elements and ignoring the undefined. And if it is considering 3, that means he's, if the length comes as 3, that means Chrome is considering undefined as well. Now, let's do a quick try on a home assignment, one of the home assignment programs which is already given in your workspace. So, your typing is not required from your side. Let me try this. And one of you has to come forward to explain me why the answer is coming the way it is coming. Have a look. I declared array colors holding 3 colors, red, blue, and green. You know very well that right now the length of colors is 3 because it's holding 3 elements. But what you have done in the next step is this flexibility JavaScript has. You have taken the colors array dot length and you have equated to 2. The moment you made the length equal to 2, that means you have reduced the length of the current array. So length, understand, the length of the original array is 3, but you have reduced it to 2. Therefore, when you say colors of 2, naturally you will get the output as undefined. Why? Because if the length of the colors array is 2, then it is only supposed to have 2 elements, no? One at the index 0, other at the index 1. How will it have an element at the index 2? Is it possible? So, if I go here and print the element at index 0, I'll definitely get an answer. See? I print the element at index 1, I'll definitely get the answer. See? Because the length is 2, it holds only 2 elements. So, Rocky sir, are you trying to say that because you made length equal to 2, so the last element got cut off? Exactly. The last element, unfortunately, got cut off. Like a scissor, you just cut it from here. Okay. Now, I want one of you to confirm. Is this home assignment program already there in your workspace or not? And if it is there, you will please run it right now.
It is there.
Perfect. Very good. Please run it right now. And it is done. You will say done on the chat. Doubts, you will please ask. Okay, Manish is done, very good. Vishwajit done. Okay, no doubts, it seems so. Others waiting. I'm waiting for others. Okay, so friends, as all of you have confirmed, I think time that we move further. Waiting for Pratik, only Pratik has yet to confirm.
Done?
Okay. Right, so friends, let's move on to object literals. Now, to create an object is super simple in JavaScript. And there are total 3 ways of doing it. This is the first and the easiest way of doing it. So object according to JavaScript is nothing but a key value pair enclosed in brace brackets. If you can think of anything which can be written as key value pairs and dumped into a pair of brace bracket, then that thing is going to be called as an object in JavaScript. Simple. Let's take this example. Here, I'm making a variable car, but because the variable car is having a brace bracket here, therefore, we say that this is an object. Anything which you see starts with a pair of brace bracket and has key value pair, don't even think again, it's an object. Next, who are the key value pairs here? So there is a key called my car holding value Maruti. There is a key called get car, which seems is calling a function. No? This looks like a function call, because you have written some name, you have opened a bracket and a passing parameter. If you scan the whole code, you will find that function also. See? Oh, interesting. So Honda is being passed here and the return value is car name is Honda, which comes here. Okay, what is special colon sales? Is it a string? No. See, if sales would have been a string, then it would have been written in double quotes, no? Like this. So, agar sales mein double quote nahi hai, to 100% wo koi string nahi. So, then what is sales? So, scan the code. See, you will see a variable called sales holding Toyota. Simple. So, special is actually holding the variable value Toyota. Now, document.write, we are trying to print all the three variables, car.mycar, car.getcar and car special. Teenon ko hum log print karne wale. Okay, let's see this. Just a second, let me ask you, by the way, if car.mycar prints, I hope everybody agrees it will print Maruti. Car.getcar prints, what will be the output? Anybody, what will be the output?
In car.getCar, we will get the value car name is base Honda.
Correct. Car name is Honda is going to be the output of this line. Perfect. And notice one more thing. Instead of writing car, which is the name of the object, dot operator, special, which is the name of the key or the property in the object, you can of course write like this. Car dot special, but you can also write like this in square brackets the word special, and you're putting special in double quotes. So there are two ways to access the property of an object. All these keys, my car, get car and special, are called as properties. Therefore we say pair of property names and values. So, जो तीन प्रॉपर्टीज हैं आपके ऑब्जेक्ट के, पहला प्रॉपर्टी ये है, दूसरा प्रॉपर्टी ये है, तीसरा ये है. To access the three properties of my object, I have two ways of doing it. First, I can say object name dot property name. Second, object name in the square brackets, you write the properties name in double quotes. So, Rocky sir, can we access all these three properties that way? Exactly, you can access. So, for example, I can access get car like this also. Because after all, get car is a property. So, you can access a property in two ways. One is by dot operator and one is by square brackets. Although, everybody prefers to access by dot operator because that is quick to type. Simple. There is a program here for which you have to find an output. So I think it's time that we come to our workspace. In your workspace, there is a very big combined program. Don't go for that big combined program. Let me search for what we need right now. And let me punch that to you also. Let me put this in the script tag. If you're ready with the code as I am ready on my board, on the board, please tell me yes. Okay, Dubey is ready, waiting for others. Great. So almost all of you are ready. Correct. मैंने already आपको code punch किया हुआ है chat पर. This is the same part of the code which I have taken. Or you could even take the code from your workspace. Okay. Now, if I look, whenever I make a variable, it is having a pair of brace bracket. Within the brace bracket, I have key. That is property value. Whenever your property value pair, don't even think twice. You can declare that you are making a object. Simple. So instead of Macintosh, let me put the MacBook. Macintosh is a full form of Mac actually. So I made a variable called Apple. I made an object called Apple. Where the first property type is MacBook. The color is silver. I'm making some changes to my code. Color is silver. Get info is a third property. So the three properties in all: type, color, get info. The third property called get info, my friend, is referring to a function, as you could see here. I'm sure you'll be wondering, अरे रॉकी सर ये फंक्शन को नाम क्यों नहीं है? Good question. So whenever you declare functions, so whenever you make functions inside an object, you will never give them names. These functions are referred by the property name assigned to it. So this function here, starting from this brace bracket going up to this brace bracket, is referred to by the property name called getInfo. Now, after you made this object, let's use it. Let's see here. Apple is my object. Not color is my property. Original value of color property is silver. And let's say I'm changing it to golden. Now, apple.color, golden, okay. Document.write is just printing some statement which you can see in double quotes. If you don't want this statement, you can delete it because this is not having any role to play with an object above. It just is a dummy print statement which is given in double quotes. Look here. Apple is your object. GetInfo is a function which you're calling. Sir, function kaise? GetInfo is a property which refers a function. Therefore, getInfo property is also called as a function. And see the way I'm calling it. I'm calling it like a function only with the brackets. So any property which refers to a function should be called like this. Okay. So getInfo is being called. Kya aap return kar rahe ho getInfo se zara dekho. Sir, what is this? It's a new thing, no? Very interesting new thing. This actually is a keyword which refers to current object. It refers to current object. So this keyword refers to current object. Therefore, whichever current object you are in, sir, I am in the Apple current object. Perfect. So Apple's color, sir, it's silver. Mm-hmm. Apple's color's old value was silver. Now Apple's color value is golden. Remember, line number 4 you gave it silver, na? But line number 10 what you gave? Golden. So you should look at the latest value. And this dot type, type we never changed. Type is still MacBook. That's right. Therefore, this keyword refers to the current object. If you want, you can put this in as a comment in your workspace file. If not, no problem. It is already given in the printed notes. So don't take so much of stress. Let us go here and run this. See the output. Output of apple.getInfo. ये लाइन किसके वजह से आया? ये इसके वजह से आया. 11th लाइन के वजह से. Okay, what is this golden MacBook Apple? That is because of this getInfo. GetInfo first prints the color, then prints the type, then prints the word Apple. Golden MacBook Apple. Right? I hope you are all getting it. And even you would make the alterations to your code so that you also get a similar output. I'm giving you 2 minutes for doing your code. Please do it. Doubts, please ask. If done, say on the chat, Apple done. Very good. So Manish, Dubey, Prateek, Biswajit say Apple done. Waiting for Vinayak and Patel. Patel says also done. Very good.
Sir.
Yeah, please ask me your doubts.
Just like in the previous, the car was a problem. They have got out by using that double inverted comma special. Can we also access the data similar way like this also?
Yes, we can.
After box bracket and then the double inverted quotes get in.
Perfect. Let's do it right away. But please remember, get info is a function, huh? It's a function which you're calling. So if you call the function, not as a function, you're calling it as a property. So it will print the whole function for you. So if you don't want the output of the get info property, but rather if you want to call it, then you would probably have to remove this from the dot operator back and access it by using the dot operator. If you have a non-function variable, example, if you have a data member like type, this is a non-function variable, type, color. If you wish to access them, you're welcome. To access them like, you know, this is a way of accessing like an array. You're having this array kind of notation. So you're treating the object like an array and you're trying to access its properties. But even getInfo got accessed. Aisa nahi ki wo access nahi hua. But what will happen is that when you access the property by using double quotes, then it is blindly going to return to you what is given ahead of it. So if you wish to execute that property, then you have to call it by using dot operator.
Okay.
Yeah? Right. Now, as we discussed, we will be reaching to the doom part, document object model. Fundamentally, friends, document object model basically means that every element of HTML, frankly, should be considered as a node of a tree. So if I have, let's say, a very simple HTML code in which I have the body, I have the head. Head has title. Body has the form and a div. So all these things actually get internally inside the browser. We feel our browser is holding our data as a HTML code. No, it is not. It is not. The browser actually makes a DOM tree, document object model tree. And this object, document object model tree, goes something like this. So we are having the document, which is the whole web page. Object, we are considering every major tag. So this is a tag called body, which has become the first node or rather root node of my DOM tree. Although it is not the root node, because iske upar ek aur level aata hai HTML ka, tag ka, uske upar aata hai pura complete document ka. But what I have drawn on the board, here body is definitely acting as a root. Body has further two tags within itself. One is the head tag, so it becomes a head node. Other is a body, so it becomes a body node. The head further, let's say, has a title. So title tag again becomes a child to the head, or rather head is a parent of title. So another way around, I can notice that I've divided the whole web page into nodes. Consider each node to be an object. So what you're doing is, aap apne pure document ko, document aapka HTML ka page hai, aap apne pure document ko, pure HTML page ko represent kar rahe ho in the form of objects or in the form of nodes. So we say DOM. So you are modeling the whole document as objects. So iska kya fayda hai? Iska ye fayda hota hai ki jab JavaScript ya jQuery ya JavaScript ka koi framework aap le lijiye, example Angular, React, it becomes very quick to access any element of the web page by the means of its ID or by the means of its name. Right now, let me do the code along with you with respect to accessing the elements with respect to ID. As we know, when we create HTML, we do give IDs to all the nodes or all the tags. Using that ID, I'm able to access all the elements within JavaScript. How? Let us see. I have a dummy piece of code. This is just a code snippet. Isme keval script ka part diya hua hai, HTML part missing hai. So let us straight go to our code file here, and in the code file, please move across and come to this topic called three ways to access an HTML element in JavaScript. उसमें पहले वाले में आइए, get element by ID के example में आइए. आपको example मिल गया तो आप मुझे कहोगे yes on the chat, so that I can start explaining the example. Good. Dubey says yes. Others please scroll, scroll. काफी नीचे की तरफ आता है. Very nice. Okay. So almost all have been able to find the example. Let's see this. So friends, what we are doing now is, I have a script open, script close, body open, body close. Never ever, get my words clear, never ever go to the script part first. Pehle hamesha HTML ke body ko scan kar lo to know what all elements are there in HTML. And once you know the elements in HTML, then you should go to the script part and check the script. Okay? So let's see this. I am going into my body. The first element in my body is the div. Can you, anyone in the batch, please tell me what is contained in this div, or is this div empty? कम ऑन क्विक, क्या ये डिव एम्प्टी है, डिव में कुछ है?
सर डिव में हमने एक आईडी बना के रखा है, टेस्ट कर।
आईडी इज नॉट अ पार्ट ऑफ द, आईडी इज नॉट कंटेन्ड इन द डिव, नो। डिव के अंदर क्या, मैंने पूछा, कुछ है डिव के अंदर?
कुछ ही नहीं है।
एग्जैक्टली, सिंपल आंसर, डिव के अंदर कुछ नहीं है। और डिव की जो आईडी है वो उसका एट्रीब्यूट है। ऐसे तो बहुत सारे एट्रीब्यूट्स हम डिव को डिफाइन कर सकते हैं, डिव के अंदर कुछ कंटेंट नहीं है। तो अगर इस पेज को देखा जाए, नॉर्मली इस पेज को आप देखोगे तो आपको डिव में कुछ दिखाई नहीं देगा। सो फॉर एग्जांपल, इफ आई रन दिस पेज, दिस इज अ लॉगिन नेम। भैया लॉगिन नेम और जो टेक्स्ट बॉक्स यहाँ पर आ रहा है वो तो अगला चीज है, लॉगिन नेम इनपुट टाइप टेक्स्ट, देयर इज अ डिफरेंट थिंग। डिव इज अबाउट इट एक्चुअली, हियर देयर इज अ डिव, बट नथिंग इज विजिबल बिकॉज डिव हैज नथिंग इनसाइड इट। Yes, the div is having ID called test. इसका मतलब अगर आप div को access करना चाहते हो तो आपको test ID या ये उसका नाम हो गया div का, इसके जरिए उसको access करना पड़ेगा। देखिए access कैसे करते हैं, जरूर करते हैं, patience रखिए। Login name input type text has a small event defined. The event is on blur. Please recall last week's JavaScript theory. We saw some events: on click, on blur, on focus, on select, on double click, etc., etc., etc. On blur कब होता है? When somebody loses focus. So, if you lose focus, that means if you come out of the text box, that time the text box loses focus, due to which on blur happens. And whenever on blur happens, I'm calling the function, some function called find length. Have a look here. Let me run this piece of code for a second and see what happens. I've typed abc123, I press tab. Ah, interesting. So when I press tab, jo div upar khali pada hua tha, usme aa gaya count of characters is 6. Yeah, exactly, I've got 6 characters. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and tab, got 9 characters, that's right. Therefore, how is this function working? Let's see. First thing, document dot get element by ID name means you are accessing the element whose ID has name. Oh, whose ID is having name? Look, input type text box, ID equal to name, as well as name is also equal to name. That's a good practice, that you should give the same name for the ID, you should give the same name for the name attribute also. I know you will say, Rocky sir, do ko do depend karke kya fayda ho raha hai? Aap is element ko ID se access kar sakte ho na? Bilkul kar sakta. But what happens if this page was supposed to call a PHP page also? Wo bhi to dekha hai na aapne last week. If you call this page, if I put a form here and I submit the form, in PHP this input type text box will be accessed by its name, not by its ID. But in JavaScript right now I'm accessing the element by its ID. Okay, that's the reason whenever we code an HTML page, always give ID as well as name. ID will be greatly beneficial and useful for JavaScript to access the element, and name would be useful for PHP or Python to access your element. Depends on what is running in tier 2. Tier 2 mein kaun si programming language run kar rahi hai, Java, Python ya PHP? Tino ko name convenient hota hai element ko access karna. They will access your element by name, not by ID. Okay, right. Now JavaScript says document kaun hai, ye pura web page, ye jo pure web page mein khade ho na, test.html, ye pura web page document kehlata hai. उसको आप बोल रहे हो, इमेजिन डॉक्यूमेंट इज अ ह्यूमन इन फ्रंट ऑफ यू, आप उसको बोल रहे हो, डॉक्यूमेंट कैन यू प्लीज गेट मी द एलिमेंट हुज आईडी इज नेम? ही सेज यस, व्हाई नॉट, ही गेट्स इट फॉर यू, ही गेट्स दिस होल इनपुट टाइप टेक्स्ट बॉक्स फॉर यू। डू यू वांट द टेक्स्ट बॉक्स कंप्लीट और यू वांट ओनली व्हाट इज टाइप्ड इनसाइड इट? नो, आई वांट ओनली व्हाट इज टाइप्ड इनसाइड द टेक्स्ट बॉक्स। कूल, से डॉट वैल्यू। सो डॉट वैल्यू विल एक्सेस व्हाटएवर यू हैव टाइप्ड and dump it in the variable str. Next, document once again is the whole web page, and you are asking document, listen, can you get me that element whose ID is test? He says, yes, why not? Who's the element with the ID test? This one, for div. Oh, so div has come in your hand, yes. What do you want to do? You want to just access the div and forget it? No. I want to put something in the div. Correct. You want to put something in the div. If you want to read something out of the div, or if you want to put something into the div, you have to use inner HTML. So now notice this very simple funda. If you write dot inner HTML on the left side, on the left hand side, and you say equal to some value on the right hand side, then you are actually assigning data to the div. Next, you write dot value on the left, and you are assigning some value to it. Then you are assigning data to the input type. It could be anything. It could be input type text, input type password, input type email, input type date, input type checkbox, input type radio button, endless. Koi bhi input type ko aap data de sakte. So any input type element you can assign data. Simple rule: whenever you have input type elements, always use dot value. Whenever you have a div or a span or a para, div, span, para. Then you should use inner HTML. Again, the thumb rule. If this thing comes on the left hand side, what comes? Dot inner HTML, dot value. Agar expression ke left hand side mein aata hai, to aap data assign kar rahe. And if I reverse it, that means I put that dot value dot HTML on the right hand side, then you're not assigning value, you are extracting value. Example, str is equal to, you're getting access to some text box, suppose you're saying dot value. Dot value kahan likha hai aapne? So right hand side mein likha hai. So if you write dot value on the right hand side, then you are not giving value, you are extracting value from the input type text or input type password or input type whatever input type is there. Similarly, if you are writing dot inner HTML on the right hand side of the expression, same applies here also. But this, I'll just change the term here as element. Then I am extracting value from the div or a span or the para. From the div or the span or the para. So simple rule to remember. I'm going to punch that on the WhatsApp group now. Not on the Google chat, will be lost now. So the rule is very simple. This is LHS. So if these are things like dot inner HTML, dot value, agar wo LHS side mein aate hain, left hand side mein aate hain, so you are assigning. Ye simple tarika yaad rakhne ka. LHS mein aa raha hai, to aap assign kar rahe ho. Aur agar wahi cheez right hand side mein aati hai, to aap assigning nahi kar rahe. Kya kar rahe ho dosto, batao mujhe. Correct. We are extracting. Perfect. Okay, so I'm going to put this right now on the WhatsApp so that none of us miss this. Okay. Right. Now, have a look how this piece of code is working. Okay, quick question to all of you. Where is dot value coming? This is an entire line number 5 ka jo entire expression hai. Where is dot value coming? Right hand side, left hand side?
Right hand side.
Matlab, so what are you doing? Extracting or assigning?
Assign.
Extracting. Extracting. Correct. The rule says if dot value dot in, dot and dot inner HTML, dot value or dot inner HTML, if it comes on the right hand side, you are extracting. Simple. So you extract kar rahe ho data isme se, and you are dumping it in the variable str. Next. Quick, another quick question. Where is dot inner HTML coming? Left hand side or right hand side? Left hand side of the expression. So what are you doing? Assigning or extracting?
Assigning.
Simple as that. So humne kya kiya, jo bhi kuch aapne text box mein type kiya hai usko aap leke aaye variable str mein. Next, aapne str mein jo kuch hai uska length find kiya. That means whatever is here, you found the length of it. Length find karne ke baad, you are concatenating it to this dummy string, number of characters space. So obviously you get number of characters 9. And that you are dumping, you are assigning to the div whose ID is test. Therefore, things are visible to you on the screen. My friend, if the div test was not there, then how will it be visible? Let's say the test div initially contained the word hello. But moment you type something here and press a tab key, tab ke wajah se aapka control isme se bahar nikal jata hai. So hello is replaced. So div mein jis pe hello tha got replaced with number of characters equal to 6. I hope this is crystal clear to each one. Please execute your code immediately right now. And if it's done and on clear, you will say on the chat all clear. Doubt, you will quickly ask. Vishwajit says done. Pratik says done. Good. Waiting for others. Okay, Manish says done. Dubey says done. Vinayak done. Waiting for Patel. Perfect. Good. So, friends, that I believe ends our session for today.